I'm Erik Bacharach, MLB reporter for Sports Business Journal, and here is the latest on the MLB labor negotiations. Major League Baseball remains at odds with the Players Association, even after 8 straight days of negotiations between the two sides in Jupiter, Florida. Those negotiations really began to pick up steam on Monday during a 16-hour marathon of talks in which the two sides appeared to be inching closer to bridging the gaps on many of the key issues in play, so much so that they actually moved back the deadline to reach an agreement on a new CBA into Tuesday. But some of those gaps, especially the luxury tax, the pre-arbitration bonus pool, proved insurmountable. And now baseball finds itself in what is, you know, only can be described as the nightmare scenario. Rob Manfred on Tuesday canceled the first 2 series of the season, meaning the earliest it could start conceivably would be April 8th. But even that kind of seems like a long shot, given the way things tapered off in Jupiter and how much work there is still to be done to find some middle ground on key economic issues. USA Today's Bob Nightingale reported that the negotiations could resume as early as Thursday in New York. Three of the key economic issues that the owners and unions still can't agree on are minimum salary for players, the newly created pre-arbitration bonus pool, and the all-important competitive balance tax or the luxury tax, plus the penalties for stepping over that threshold. So let's start there. The CBT this past year was $210 million. Only 2 teams, the Dodgers and the Padres, exceeded it in 2021. As it kind of served as the soft cap. If there's a key issue in play, it's really this one. The MLBPA initially sought a CBT of $245 million, but has since decreased that ask to $238 million in 2022, while MLB's latest proposal included a CBT of $220 million, meaning there's still an $18 million gap between the two sides, and that difference only grows through each year of the 5 years of the new CBA. The pre-arbitration bonus pool is a new feature to the CBA, which draws money from the league revenues, and would be awarded to not yet arbitration eligible players based on a number of statistical variables, and it's yet another point of contention. MLB's latest offer included a $30 million pre-arb bonus pool, while the MLBPA is at $85 million. So just doing some quick math there, $55 million difference between the two sides that, again, only continues to grow with each passing year of the new CBA. On league minimum salaries, that third key economic issue, the union and the owners are a bit closer there with a $25,000 difference between them for the 2022 season, with MLB offering a $700,000 minimum and the PA seeking a $725,000 minimum. Last week, the difference there was $135,000. So some real progress there made in the flurry of negotiations that took place ahead of Tuesday's deadline. And then, you know, I would say another key variable in the mix here is how many teams compete in the postseason. The owners want a 14-team playoff system. The union doesn't want to go above 12. Rob Manfred, during a press conference on Tuesday, said that the league was, in fact, willing to move forward with a 12-team postseason, but that proposal would reportedly require the union to concede in a few other areas. Obviously, there are some other issues in play, but those are the big ones, and those are still some big gaps there. As MLBPA Director Tony Clark said during Tuesday's press conference, still a lot of work to be done. Yeah, this outcome, the cancellation of regular season games, is something that Manfred said just a couple of weeks ago would be, quote, disastrous for the sport. And that's what it is. There's no way to spin it. It's an absolute disaster without question. One of the darkest moments for Major League Baseball in its history. And keep in mind, this comes on the heels of 2 COVID-impacted seasons for Major League Baseball, plus amid a lot of, you know, other turmoil around the world. You know, just to think that there couldn't be an agreement in place before it got to the point where, you know, games had to be canceled. It's almost unthinkable. And I think arguably the most disappointing part of all of this, you know, just kind of stepping back and looking at the process, is kind of the timeline of how the negotiations played out. You know, MLB imposed the lockout in early December, and the league waited 6 weeks to circle back to the union. And even then, you know, it was really kind of only baby steps. Things didn't really begin to gain momentum till the two sides arrived in Jupiter. And it seems the owners were determined to prolong the process until the 11th hour to see if the union would cave. So now here we are. And remember, this isn't 1994 when the last MLB work stoppage took place. Looking at just the competing entertainment options now versus then, in the overall landscape, it's night and day. You know, baseball was struggling even before the labor dispute in that regard, and really can't afford this type of blow. From here, things only get more complicated. Will the union try to bargain for 162 game season? You know, if not, what does an 156 game season mean for service time? Are more games going to be canceled? There's just a slew of complications born from the cancellation of games that only further muddies the outlook of this situation. The players have been incredibly unified to this point, but will that continue, you know, as their paychecks become impacted? The owners are reportedly prepared to miss all of April, when it comes to regular season games. Will that hold true as we move forward? Right now it's a staring contest, and neither side is blinking. And right now there's no end in sight. For Sports Business Journal, I'm Erik Bacharach.